See, we have to know that Jesus is God, because if we don't know that, we're not going to make it. Why are children and why are adults in prison today? For the sake of the name of Jesus Christ, because he's God, he's very God. That's the witness, okay? That's the truth. Why are they in prison? For a false God? For a false truth? He is God, very God. See? In the flesh. Once again, the Holy Spirit came into that egg cell in Mary's womb and boom. See? It's a holy, holy thing. Don't let the devil lie to you and tell you Jesus is not God, equal with the Father, because he is. He's equal with the Father. That is an antichrist spirit speaking to your mind. If you believe Jesus is a little bit lower than the Father, that's an antichrist spirit. See? Jesus always gave the glory to the Father. And what did the Father do? He gave the glory to the Son. See? And the Holy Spirit's right there. See? Father, glorify thy name, you know. And what a voice came out of heaven. They heard, I have glorified it and will glorify it again. See, who? Jesus. See, Jesus said, Father, glorify thy name. And the Father says, I have glorified it and will glorify it. He's talking to his Son. See, it's very, very beautiful to know that Jesus Christ is God and that he suffered for us and died for us. It's wonderful. It's beyond comparison. It's something you know in your heart. It's something that is so wonderful and beautiful and true. And then the devil comes along casting doubt in your mind, casting doubt here and casting doubt there. You got to cast that out. You got to get rid of the devil's lies and believe what the word says. Jesus said, hallelujah, verily, verily, I say unto you, before Abraham was, I am. Hallelujah. I am. John chapter 8. Jesus said he was, and he is. Hallelujah. Praise God. And that's enough right there. But I'm going to go ahead and read John chapter 10. I and my Father are one. Okay. Chapter 10, verse 30. I and my Father are one. Okay. I'm going to go ahead and go over here to John 14. Okay. And I'll leave you with this because I think of... pretty much helped you to understand that Jesus Christ is God, and you need to believe it. You don't have to understand it. You don't have to figure out God. You can't figure him out. You worship him. You love him. You say, oh, hallelujah. See, why try to figure it out? What, do you want to be bigger than God? What, do you want to be smarter than him? Huh? Jesus is so different than us. He's so awesome, so holy, so pure. We're just beginning to, you know, get our toes in the water. And he wants us to come out into the middle of that river, you know, and let it just take us. But most of us are just dabbling in ankle-deep water because we're afraid. Let's go in. Let's go into the river. Hallelujah. He said here in John 14, Thomas said to him, Lord, we know not whither thou goest, and how can we know the way? Jesus says unto him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. Hallelujah. If ye had known me, ye should have known my Father also, and from henceforth ye know him and have seen him. Wow, that's very interesting, isn't it? Philip says unto him, Lord, show us the Father, and that sufficeth us. Show us the Father. Jesus just said, if you know, it's amazing, the apostles. Jesus said to him, have I been so long time with you, and yet hast thou not known me, Philip? He that has seen me has seen the Father. You see, they're one. They do nothing apart, nothing. See? The Father was with Jesus, okay, when he was on the cross, the Father was there, but that one moment, that one final moment, the Father looked away And Christ Jesus cried out, my God, why hast thou forsaken me? Because in his humanity, he was just felt lost. Have you ever felt lost? My God, why have you forsaken me? And in his humanity, he felt forsaken and lost. And then he gave up the ghost. And he wasn't lost. He accomplished what the Father sent him forth to do. And because he did, hallelujah, we are saved today. And we know it. We have the assurance of our salvation. We have the assurance of our salvation. We have the witness within ourselves, as 1 John chapter 5 tells us. We are in the Son. And those who are in the Son, okay, because eternal life is in the Son, then we have eternal life. Jesus said in John 5 that those who believe on him have eternal life. See, right now. You don't have to wait. You can have it now. But you have to repent of your sins. And that's the self life. All the self, the self, the self. See, the self life in the mind, trying to reason and figure out all these questions in the Bible, all these different verses. Don't let the devil take you down that road. Just believe the Word of God and love God and let God just show you and bless you with his truth. Okay, his Son, Jesus Christ of Nazareth, is God in the flesh. And there's no doubt about it. I'm not going to debate with anybody about it. I'll share what I know to be true from the scripture. There's so much more. The book of Isaiah is just filled with prophecies about the Lord Jesus Christ. The book of Zechariah is filled with prophecies about the Lord Jesus Christ. Ezekiel, Jeremiah, all the prophets, okay, and Numbers and Deuteronomy and Exodus, which all points to Christ. He is very God and very man. I can't explain it, and don't ask me to explain it, and I don't have to explain it to you, because it's incumbent upon the Lord to give you grace, to pour his grace upon you, to believe, okay? And if he doesn't do it, then I'll pray that he will, you know. Father, I do pray that you pour your grace upon the hearer of this message, Lord, and let them receive your grace unto belief, Lord, unto faith. Okay, unto repentance, O God, to just know that you, Lord Jesus, are the Almighty God. Hallelujah. Almighty, everlasting Father. Hallelujah. In Jesus' name. Amen.